Today, I'm going to show you how you can use AI to analyze blockchain smart contracts. These are skills you can put to use to create awesome on-chain analytics like those you see here, or to help you start learning how to become a smart contract developer or auditor for yourself. Now, what's revolutionary about what I'm going to show you today is that you don't have to be a genius or coding expert to use them and get started. On-chain data guru Andrew Hong is building a Telegram chatbot which will help generate this kind of analysis through a simple conversational process. Just one of the awesome things we'll be looking at today. Let's go. So in case you hadn't heard, AI is profoundly changing the way we do knowledge work. One of the areas in which it appears to be most performant and ready for immediate use is in the realm of coding and computer programming. I used AI to teach myself how to apply SQL and Python earlier this year, languages which were both new to me, and it helped me build this awesome analytics dashboard on June. I shared my learnings from this experience in a totally free course, which you can view on this channel and for which you can download the slides for on my website. And well, if I'd thought I'd made strident progress then, what I've managed to do since makes even all of that seem like nothing. The core message that I was driving home in this course is that the more you know about the system you are trying to work with and what you are trying to achieve, the better the instructions you will be able to give your AI and the more powerful those AI tools are going to become in your hands. I've run into some good fortune recently. After a considerable dry spell searching for good work, I published this June dashboard, and that earned me a good deal of positive attention, including an old client reaching out saying that they needed help with an on-chain analytics dashboard. But their situation was really different to what I had been doing on June. Once again, sure, I had to analyze blockchain data that included activity generated by a smart contract. But this time, the smart contract had not been decoded on June, Flipside, or other SQL platforms. And that meant that I had to learn how this smart contract worked and what data it was writing to the blockchain. Data then had to be extracted from Block Explorer API and then enriched and processed using Python after being decoded and then served back to the client in an API to drive their dashboard. These requirements definitely represented a step up from what I was doing. But with the experience I already had working with AI, the work I'd done on June, and the fact that I just completed a course by Google for using Python for advanced analytics all together left me confident that I would be able to deliver this work to a professional standard with AI support. And sure enough, I was right. But when I made that call, I had no idea just how right I was. I have been totally blown away by just how straightforward it has been for me to do some pretty sophisticated work with the experience that I had at that point and learn a ton more in the process in just a little over 3 weeks, and I'm going to be sharing some of those skills and methods with you right here in a moment. But let's start off with asking this question. How do you decode blockchain data when you know the source code? You'll see why that's important in a minute. If you've ever taken a look at a Block Explorer, you know that the data looks quite crazy. You've got all these 0x hex numbers and cryptic field headers like method, inputs, topics, data. It's basically matrix code, right? Well, crypto is called crypto for a reason. It makes extensive use of cryptography. The smart contracts data looks cryptic because it's been encrypted. But this encryption has some special properties. The cryptographic values are generated by a cryptographic hash function. This function takes an input and generates an encrypted output, which by itself cannot tell you what input generated it, even if you know the hash function itself. However, the hash function will always generate the same value for a specific input. So if you know the input and you know the hash function, then you can calculate the hash and know what it refers to whenever it appears in the blockchain's code. In the context of smart contract operation and the data that it writes to the blockchain, the hashed values have a direct and unique relationship with a human-readable code that developers use to program the smart contract. And this means something quite special. If you have access to the underlying smart contract's code, then you can decode the encrypted data. And sure enough, my client developed the smart contracts that they want me to analyze, and they've published the source code on Block Explorers anyway. So I do have access to the underlying smart contract code and am able to decode the encrypted data on the blockchain. So that means that All that I have to do now is read through this code, which has been written in Ethereum's language, Solidity, and understand what the smart contract is trying to do, locate all the parts of the code that generate on-chain data. And yes, that's a lot, but this is precisely where AI comes in and frankly works miracles. Before I show you it in action, let's quickly recap what we want our AI to help us with. For on-chain analytics, we're typically interested in two kinds of coding items: functions and events. Functions are things that the smart contract can do, and events are records of what the smart contract actually does. These two things are linked together in that it takes a function to emit an event, but that event will only be emitted if that's been programmed for in the function itself. So when we are looking for information on chain to understand what's going on, what the smart contract is doing, we're typically either looking at function calls, times that users have used or called these functions, or are looking at the events that have been emitted or recorded by these smart contract function calls. So we need to look for function and event calls in this code to do two things. Firstly, to be able to decode the blockchain data in the first place. And then secondly, to understand intrinsically what these functions are doing and what events they are recording so that we understand how to interpret that blockchain data. And that's just what I'm going to do right now with AI. So I typed in Uniswap V3 factory address into Google. I've got the address there. Actually, it turns out the first result is Etherscan anyway. I copy that address, I put it into Etherscan if that's not what's come up, and I should be seeing this transactions table, but you can go into this tab here called contract, and it actually contains the underlying smart contract code of this contract written in Solidity. So I can just highlight the whole thing here. You've got some real cool features now. You can actually open up an integrated development environment to allow you to play with this code. But I'm going to do something like super simple here. Just select all, copy it. And I'm going to go into ChatGPT and I'm going to say, I'm going to do my normal superstitious thing. Please act as an expert in Solidity and smart contract development. I don't think these preliminary prompts are as necessary these days, but I'm just doing it anyway to help anchor the context of the AI in a space that's, you know, relevant to Solidity and smart contracts and blockchain stuff. And my next question is going to be a pretty general one. Please, you know, I'm not even going to put in any fancy technical stuff. I'm just going to say, please, let me make this bigger. Help me understand what this smart contract does. And I'm going to paste the whole thing in here and send it over. And there we go, is a factory contract for deploying Uniswap V3 liquidity pools. It controls the deployment and configuration of these pools, managing key parameters. So I've already got a fair amount of information, some stuff about ownership management, who gets to give it orders, fee configuration. There's a whole bunch of stuff that's come back, and you saw that it came back lightning fast. Now, I shouldn't be relying on this 100%. I should read it carefully and then go and double check it with the code myself. But this really helps accelerate how we get started. Like, instead of just really knowing absolutely nothing and having to work things out line by line, I now have a reliable depiction of what this thing does approximately that gives me some orientation when I go and look at that code. But absolutely, you know, stay critical, bring your own mind to it. But this definitely saves you time, and at the level of reliability and development this AI has gotten to now, you really can trust that it's giving you good feedback. And actually, because of the way these AIs have been trained, if you're examining a well-known smart contract like Uniswap, it has a ton of information about how that works. So you can be confident that what comes back is going to be even more accurate and reliable. But there's plenty more that I can do here. I can take advantage of the knowledge that I have about how smart contracts work and what information I'm trying to decode from the blockchain data and what I need to do that to craft a much more specific prompt. So let me just paste in that code again. I'm superstitious sometimes. I know that's probably already in the context. I'm just going to put in code. And I've already, you know, pre-made this instruction. So let's have a look. Where have I got it here? This is a prompt I made earlier. Please create me a table that lists all the functions declared in the Solidity code below. Table should include columns for the name of the function, the line on which the function is declared, each function's parameters, whether the function's external or internal, who can call the function, what other functions can call it, and a brief description of what the function does. So off I go, send that over to ChatGPT. This is the paid version, obviously. I mean, the biggest steal of your life. I can't, you know, you have to get the paid version, guys. And I've got this table here. It's a little small to view, but I can download this. And I mean, you can see the name of the function's constructor. This doesn't have any parameters. It's an internal function. Only the deployer can call it. So it's already given me a create pool address for token A, token B, the fee. It's already given me a readout. Let's see if this came through. I can open this in an Excel file. So let's bring this over. And there I go. I have all of these headers. I have the function names here. Let me just bring that up a bit. You know, which line it occurs on, what parameters or arguments they take. And this is already giving me quite a detailed read into the contract, and it allows me to get my head around what's going on much more quickly. Here we go. What does the function do? Sorry, I'm looking below my camera there. It initializes the contract, setting the owner and default fees. This one creates a pool. This one allows. There's already a lot of context here. Now, again, you don't take this as gospel, but it gives you a starting point. It gives you an orientation, and then you go check in yourself, and you can just get started and make progress much, much, much more quickly. I could then take this GPT output and move to an AI-assisted IDE like Cursor, which everyone's talking about these days, and then use AI prompts. I don't know, you know, give it instructions like help me multiply two columns of data frames together. You give it instructions, you speak to it in English, and you can get Python code out. If you have a clear idea of what you are trying to do, and you have enough technical language to articulate that in a precise way, you will get reliable stuff back. And with data work, it's sort of different, right? You can evaluate what the machine brings back to you. I think the best analogy I've found for this is if you are in a restaurant in a foreign country, and you know what you want, the only barrier to you getting what you want is speaking the local language. But if you have an AI translator, you can make that order. And then when the dish comes back, you know if it's what you've ordered or not, because you know what you wanted. So in this context of data work, if you have sort of like clear thinking about how you want to manipulate the data, what you want it to do, you are going to be able to give the AI precise instructions, and you're going to be able to evaluate what it brings back to you reliably. Anyway, I've done tons of stuff on here. And if you haven't seen Cursor in action, you should look up this guy. He makes fantastic videos. Who have I got here? Sorry, Dave Ebelar, if I'm pronouncing it right. And this is the video, The Ultimate. No, I was reading that one earlier. Get started with Cursor, the AI code editor. And this thing has been making such huge waves. You got a Lex Friedman podcast with the Cursor team that was released just 3 weeks ago, where they talk about some of this stuff. It is truly, 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 truly revolutionary. And it is dumbfounding me and plenty of people I know with what it empowers and enables you to do. Now, it needs to be acknowledged that in order to create a prompt like the one I just did and to continue this work in the IDE in a purposeful and efficient way does require me to understand quite a bit about the task at hand. I need to know something about blockchain, the way blockchains are structured, their data. And I learned a lot of that while I was working, developing that dashboard on June. Now, the unbelievable thing is that you can bootstrap yourself your way there with the same AI. You can ask the same AI, hey, how does Ethereum work? Where does it write its data? And that's precisely what I've been doing along the way myself. But you have people out there developing tools that are making it even easier than all of that. Andrew Hong, whose teaching material got me going in on-chain analytics, who I still go to for things that I don't understand, is now working on an AI chatbot and a soon-to-be web application called Sage, which is bring this AI capability to smart contract analysis in a ChatGPT style conversational format. And it's really an incredible tool. He is testing it. It's in beta. I'm going to show you some of this stuff now. So let me just, right now it's running in Telegram. If I can find my Telegram window. Okay. So see, I did this right here. Please tell me about this contract. I put it in. Analysis failed. Let me just show you it in action. The problem was I was looking in the base on the base blockchain. I need to be looking at on Ethereum, but I'm going to type in this exactly same thing. Please tell me so you can believe that this is happening. Please tell me about this contract. say, just starting a fresh new thread. It's thinking, it's clearly leveraging some of these more advanced capabilities where, you know, it breaks down a problem into little steps in order to give you a more thorough answer. It is looking over, it has a direct link to all of these block explorers and their smart contracts. And here we go, already finished. This is the contract address. It is the Uniswap factory, V3 factory. It gives you pull creation, fee management. So it gives you a breakdown. And then it gives you some options here. You can change the level at which it answers you. Now, I've asked for a more advanced level of response by developer. I can set it to analyst, which is in the middle. Please explain the fee management function and list its parameters. You can misspell chat with these AIs. They understand what you mean anyway, but there we go. And it will continue giving you this information. You can see that it gives you links to all the other smart contracts that it relates to. So this is something that goes beyond what I was showing you on ChatGPT. This AI understands contexts and interconnections that exist between related contracts, which make it especially powerful. There's some crazy features that Andrew is developing where you can sign up to feeds of the most popular trending contracts that have recently been deployed so you can get updates. Anyway, go to his Twitter channel, connect with him there. He's posting about this sort of stuff. I really encourage you to do that. So, I mean, this is absolutely unbelievable. I mean, this would have helped me make miles of progress even just a few months ago. And it's here now. You know, this would have made a lot of difference to me earlier this year. The pace of change is just so absolutely rapid. So if you're still watching this video and have not already connected with Andrew, that's an absolute must for you. And I'm sharing details on the screen right now. Anyway, this is a completely new world, guys. And the barriers to doing any of this sort of stuff have come way, way, way down. I am still leveraging technical knowledge to do this work and to scrutinize what the AI is bringing back to me. But it is inconceivable that I would have made this much progress this rapidly without the help of AI. Guys, seriously, if you ever wanted to code, just get on board. There's never been a better time for blockchain or anything else you want to do.